what's the longest you've gone without a shower? According to this TikTok, which talks about the dangers of showering in regular tap water, the longer, the better.
Water we bathe in, like I was saying, could actually be more dangerous than what we ingest. How could that be?
Yeah, it's true.
This guy claims that showering is dangerous because the chlorine in the tap water is absorbed through your skin. Having showered all of my life in tap water, this seemed a little bit suspicious. It's time to find out. Is this legit? Hey everyone, I'm Maggie, and welcome back to Is This Legit? A series brought to you by MediaWise and PBS NewsHour Student Reporting Labs, where we fact-check viral claims and teach you some media literacy tips along the way. Anytime you're unsure about a claim you see online, your first step should always be to examine the source. This TikToker is urging people to invest in a water filter. So I looked at his profile, which has tons of other videos on the supposed dangers of regular tap water. I also found his link tree in his bio, which is just links to a ton of other sites about water filters. Looks like he is a distributor for a company called Kangen Water Systems, which sells pretty pricey water filters. Since his entire platform is trying to promote water filters, we can tell that he isn't sharing this video just for the science. But I wanted to investigate a little bit further. Since his TikTok shares a clip from a news video, I searched showering with chlorine dangers on YouTube, and I also added the keywords morning blend, which I can see in the background of the clip. The original video clip is the first one to appear. It's from a KGUM TV morning news station in Tucson, Arizona. The man speaking is named Dirk Chamberlain, who is associated with H2O Concepts, which is a company that sells water filters. Since he's talking about chlorine in showers and he sells a product related to that, we can tell that there is already a bias. Again, it looks like he's trying to sell us the product. But is his claim about chlorine in showers being bad true? He says,
you know, the EPA says we get 300 to 600 times the levels of chlorine in there that they think are safe.
So I did a keyword search for EPA shower water chlorine, and I found this research from the EPA, which says showering with chlorinated water poses little risk because monochloramine does not easily enter the air. Monochloramine is a combination of chlorine and ammonia that has been used as a disinfectant in tap water since the 1930s. That sounded pretty reassuring, but I still wanted to see what the internet has to say. Here's another tip. Leave the platform where you find a claim and open up other tabs so that you can read multiple sources and compare what each source says. We call this lateral reading. So I did a keyword search for showering with chlorinated water. The first 10 things I found were from websites or blogs that sold similar filter products. You need to skip right over those. This is called click restraint. Do not just click on the first website you see. Keep scrolling until you find something you can actually trust. I eventually found a credible source, the Minnesota Department of Public Health. They have a great resource explaining chlorinated water in your home. It says the chlorine is not absorbed into your body through the skin, and it does not cause any breathing problems. In fact, there is much less chlorine in your daily shower than there is in a swimming pool. So let's look more into that chlorinated water. I found this CDC article that explains why chlorine is put into water. It says using or drinking water with small amounts of chlorine does not cause harmful health effects and provides protection against waterborne disease outbreaks. So the claim that showering with chlorine is dangerous is not legit. We disprove this by finding credible health agency sources on chlorinated water and by discovering a bias in the TikToker and the man on the news. So next time you hear someone talking about a suspicious claim, ask yourself these questions. First of all, who are they? Second of all, what are they associated with? And finally, where are their facts coming from? This way you can figure out if someone is just trying to educate you or if they're pressuring you into buying their product. Well, I think that about covers it. Thank you for watching today, and make sure to like and subscribe so that you don't miss any of our fact-checking videos. Bye.
Don't compromise, be media wise.